quite surprised to get rid of Miss Weather's hiccups and change her back. How about we create a big, huge surprise in the box? Like a jack-in-the-box, but with surprises inside. Nobody will know what will pop out. Not even us. Will you create a surprise in the box with me? Great! Let's shake it up! Okay, let's start our surprise in a box with a big box for a big surprise. Which shape should we use for a big box? Oh, that square is boxy. Now we need a roundy opening on top for our surprise to pop out of. Which shape could we use? Let's try this oval. And let's add a zigzaggy handle we can turn, turn, turn to make the surprise pop out. Which shapes could we put together to make a zigzaggy handle? How about this rectangle? This rectangle and this rectangle. Yes! Drum roll, please! Boo-da-doo! Let's put all these shapes in here so we won't know what surprises will pop out. Let's get back to our story. Whoa! That's a big box, Charlie! What's inside? I'm not sure. Let's see. Let's try to hop way over the fence to get to the red shape. Yeah, I'm hopping as high as I can.
The fence is too tall.
If we had a trampoline, we could hoppity hop super high. Hey, maybe we can make one. Will you help me create a hoppy trampoline? Great. Let's shake it up! Boing! Let's start with the middle of the trampoline. We need a bouncy, wouncy, roundy shape. Which should we use? The oval! And now we need some legs to go under the bouncy part. Straight legs, like rectangles. But we don't have any rectangles. What shapes can we use to make a rectangle? Let's try these two triangles. A triangle here, triangle there. That's a rectangle. Now three more rectangles for the rest of the legs. And bounce-da-doo! A hop, hop, hoppy trampoline! Let's hop back to our board game story.
Wow!
Boingy, boing!
Okay, Charlie! Let's hop over this gate all the way to the red shape. Ready?
And hop! Shape!
A triangle! We made it!
MacGuffin! Watch out for that!
Whoa. A swirly space ball!
Yikes!
Please catch me!
This space movie hero will try! Stick with me! Can't get the MacGuffin out of the swirly space hole. Her mighty movie is getting stickier. If only the silly bots were here to help. Hey, we could make a new robot character to catch the MacGuffin starship. Like, a cat robot.
Good idea, but please hurry.
Affirmative. Will you create a cat robot with me? Let's shake it up. Okay, to make a cat robot, we'll start with the body. How about we use this rectangle? Now we need our cat robot's head. Mighty Movie Maker, which do you think looks like a kitty? The square with the triangles or the square with the ovals? Ooh, the square with the two pointy triangle ears. And now let's get creative and put rockets on our cat robot. Ooh, and special vacuum cleaner arms to catch the MacGuffin. Drum roll, please. And boop, boop, dee, dee, dot, doop.
Meow. Meow.
Meow-tastic. Let's get back to our loopy. Catbot!
At your service. Meow. Can I help you?
We need you to catch that wobbly starship.
Upper meow, Tiv. Activating. Vacuum pause.
You got this.
Meow. Frustrating. Can't catch it. Initiating ultra vacuum pause.
What could go wrong?
Whoopsie.
Whoa! That went wrong. This could only happen in a movie! Stick with me!
Whenever, wherever you need a big, big surprise!
Hey, quiet, please!
It's too loud. Oops.
Uh-oh, we need to make music for Planty, but it's too loud for our friends, the silly faces. Our story is getting stickier. How can we play music for Planty without being too loud? Yes! We could give Planty headphones! Hey, Storyteller, will you help us create headphones for Planty? Let's shake it up! Okay, let's start with the part that goes over the head, plant. What shape should we use? I know, the curvy shape. Now, let's add one of the parts where the sound comes out, next to your ear. What shape should we use? How about the circle? We need another circle for the other side. But I don't see one. What can we use instead? Oh, the two semicircles make a circle.
Whoop-a-doo! Shapey headphones!
Oh, and let's make another pair for you. So you can hear the music, too. And drum roll, please. Boo-dum-doo! Now, let's get back to our surprising story.
Sunny skies, Charlie! Those headphones are perfect for Planty.
Yeah!
Thanks. Here you go. Let's see if this works.
Look! Quack!
A plant that quacks? What? Is this the big, big, big surprise?
Nope!
Look at
see.
Wow!
A juggling plant?
What? Teddy bear!
Oh, no!
No, 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 no! Go away, Spaghetti! Stop! Shoo! Uh-oh!
Is this how our story ends? Not if we're the ones telling this story. It's time for something big to happen, like another edit. Let's freeze it.
Way to go, Charlie!
And make another change. Storyteller, what could we create to keep baby's sandcastle safe? Maybe a big beach umbrella that could stop the spaghetti.
Or maybe a big trampoline so the spaghetti will bounce off and we could do bouncy tricks too.
Or we can make both together, an umbrella-poline. Will you help me create a big spaghetti-proof umbrella-poline? Yes! Let's shake it up! Okay, we'll start with an umbrella pole that sticks in the ground. What shape could we use for a pole? This long, skinny rectangle? Yep. Next, we need the big, curvy part that goes on top. Curvy like an umbrella, and bouncy like a trampoline. Which shape should we use? Let's use this semicircle. Bouncy, wouncy. I like it. And let's decorate our umbrella-poline with beachy beach balls. Which shapes could go together to make a beach ball? How about these two semicircles? Lots of beach balls! And drum roll, please! Boo-da-doo! Now, let's get back to our surf story.
Yeah! Whee! Nice umbrella baleen, Charlie.
Thanks. And go!
Oh,
right! Yeah! Saved baby's sandcastle!